Hey guys, hey. We just landed here, and as you know, Singapore is like home for us because we lived here for so long. But we ran a poll on our Instagram, and so many of you asked for suggestions for those exploring Singapore for the first time or exploring the country on a budget. So in this video, we thought we'd share 10 must-dos in Singapore, things that everybody who visits the country for the first time should do.
And someone who's on a short stopover or a short holiday. We're just flying in from Delhi. We flew with Singapore Airlines, easy and convenient flight. I think 5 hours. We are here. We're ready to explore and maybe meet some of our friends as well.
So the best thing to get you started in exploring Singapore is to get a Singapore Explorer Pass.
Yep.
You just need to show your boarding pass, and there's a counter at the airport itself. That's where we're headed next. And the Explorer Pass actually gives you free entry to a lot of attractions in Singapore. In addition to that, you also get a SIM card and lots of free meals that are included.
That's pretty cool.
And in this video, we'll try and include attractions and things to do that are included in the Explorer Pass or are free of cost.
Just to make things easy for you guys.
A penny on top of that.
Absolutely. So let's go pick them up and go exploring Singapore. But don't wait for too long. Just hold me. We're right where we belong. Don't have what you need. We'd suggest that one day come to Sentosa. I mean, you can spend longer, but I think one day is ideal. Start at Mount Faber, take the cable car right into Sentosa, and then once you get here, out of the 11 premium attractions here in Sentosa, you can choose one with your Singapore Explorer Pass, and we would definitely recommend choosing the Luge. It's amazing. You go downhill in a go-kart and it's a great experience. We did it like 3 or 4 times, so definitely go for that. And then have lunch at Good Old Days. Just take a stroll on the beach. It can get crowded, but it's still pretty. So we'd say spend a nice long day at Sentosa. End your visit to Sentosa by walking to Resorts World, Sentosa Island. There's a beautiful candy store. There's Universal Studios, if that's the kind of thing that you like. We suggest going to Adventure Cove Water Park. We loved our time here. There's great energy. Some of the rides are amazing. We tried the Rainbow Reef and the Adventure River and the dueling race or something, but definitely worth the time. One afternoon, just head to Little India, do the heritage walk, go to the heritage center. There's so much color here, as you can see behind me. There are beautiful murals, which I'm going to show you right now. Just walk around. The chaos is amazing. It's colorful, it's vibrant. It's very unlike the Singapore that you will see outside. So definitely come here. I love the fact that Singapore is such a melting pot of modern development, of culture. You'll find these beautiful architectural buildings, and then right behind those buildings you'll find tall skyscrapers. You know, one of my other favorite areas used to be Arab Street and the area around it. Such amazing food, again, colorful buildings. So you have to come here and try the food here. My favorite used to be Prata and Murtabak.
If you're traveling with kids or want to feel like one again, you have to come for the River Safari and the Singapore Zoo. It's more like an educational endeavor, and you can learn so much about conservation and animals and all those kind of things. But if you're at the River Safari, take the Amazonian boat cruise, and you can spot
really cool
flamingos, monkeys, jaguars, so many animals, and it's so much fun.
You know, while you're here, I'm sure you'll want to eat, because you should spend a day or at least half a day here.
Half a day, yeah.
You have to go try the panda buns, the panda baos. Yeah. We tried the chocolate custard one. They're Which so cute.
It was really good. If you're even mildly interested in art, then you have to visit the National Gallery. It has some really cool exhibits. Most of them are permanent, but if you're coming before April of 2019, you have to check out the minimalism exhibition. It's so fascinating. I could spend hours here. And for photography enthusiasts, I mean people who don't want to hang around in a museum or art gallery like Vid, check out the architecture, because as you can see, the facade is so amazing. There it is. It's very unlike the rest of Singapore, so make sure you drop by. And this is also home to one of the most scenic bars in Singapore called Smoke and Mirrors. So drop by for a drink after perusing the gallery.
And one evening, just take a river cruise and float past the beautiful buildings and monuments in Singapore, some of our favorite places, and then end with dinner at Clarke. What is a visit to a new country without trying its food scene? Singapore, as you know, is a melting pot of different cultures, and that reflects so clearly in the food scene here. So you have to visit a food street. We are here at Chinatown Food Street right now. You're going to try all sorts of different cuisine. There's a lot of vegetarian options, there's a lot of non-vegetarian options, whatever floats your boat, you have to try it out.
If you're in Singapore, you must visit Chinatown. The bustling area is home to so many street food joints, restaurants, bars, and historical monuments as well. Go to the Heritage Center to get an idea of Singapore's history, and definitely go to the Tooth Relic Museum, which houses one of Buddha's teeth, but it is a gorgeous structure. Try to catch the early morning light if you want some photographs, and then head straight for some street food. Flyer is an iconic landmark in the country, and you must visit it to get a vantage point. If you're a photography enthusiast or an expert, you will love the experience because it offers such amazing views of the entire country of Singapore. If there's one attraction everybody probably sees in Singapore, it's Gardens by the Bay, and it's hyped for a reason. It's worth every single bit of the hype, so we really suggest going to both the domes and the light and sound show at sunset. Entry to both the domes is included in the Singapore Explorer Pass, and the Rhapsody show, which happens at night, is free, and we suggest doing all three things for a complete experience of Gardens by the Bay.